color they are. Charim, do you have the word of the dead with you?
Yes.
Good. Then place it in front of the beacon and prepare yourself. Prophet, it is now up to you. Somehow you must recall the moment when the last cleansing happened. If Yaela's theory is right, this is the only way to get our hands on something close to a physical form of a High One. No, but maybe you can somehow lure it. According to all that you have told me so far, the Echo seems to react to things or situations connected to the cycle. Take a look around and see if you can find something. All right.
The beacon was created to banish the High Ones from existence, but to do that, we need something from them.
Sickness is in people's heads. It is a way of thinking. But you will never understand that, High Priest. Will you?
It was almost as if the beacon longed for the stones. They are the key. I feel it. They are similar to magic, or the power responsible for the tides. They are pure energy.
Consciousness of a past civilization. Do you see that up there? Yaela was right after all. This is our Numinos, the essence of a High One.
I wish you could see this.
We are in his thoughts. What could you do against that? Time does not exist here. At least not as we know it. We will see about that. Maybe that question will answer itself. Charim, do it. Carry the container to the essence.
As you command, Aradheon.
What are you waiting for?
Tell me, Aradheon. Back in the ruins, when the High Wall showed you that memory, it was the first time I saw you express real agitation. Not anger, but agitation. What you did to your son, do you regret it, I wonder? That you abandoned him in exchange for prestige and power?
What?
I don't think you do. What got to you is being reminded of your own failure. Regret? You don't know that feeling. You never have. Not even after Kira.
China, what are you?
I hired the mercenaries. I killed the Shari when she found out. And I helped the Nerimese conquer the harbor. And I bet you still don't have the slightest idea who I am, do you?
Why, you were there. The night of a thousand fires.
Yes, I survived your massacre. One of only a few.
Then you did not follow my son because you shared his ideals. You did it to get to me. What for you now? Justice?
Justice? I am done with this world, Arithiel. I have been for a long time now. The only reason why I'm still here is a promise I made to someone. The promise that one day, I will be the one who takes everything from you.
Yusuf, this is madness. Whatever you are planning to do, it will affect the whole world, not just me. If you want my death, why not just wait, damn it? Once we have lit the beacon, Korek will kill me. That way, all those innocent lives will be.
Just shut up! You take me for such a fool! As if there's anything in this world you would want more than to die a martyr! Tealor Arithiel, conqueror of the High Ones, savior of mankind. You like the sound of that, don't you? You like it so, so much.
You know, at first, I was so frustrated with all the setbacks. When the Prophet saved Lashari's research in Aldrashengrad, and when Kuarek's first attack on the city didn't succeed. But then I realized that all of this would be so much more gratifying than anything else I could do to you. Your final attempt, and so close to your target, only to fail by my hand.
You asked me once what my daughter's name was. Do you remember?
Yes, I beg you, please.
Lena. Her name was Lena.
No. That's impossible. You fool. Miserable, selfish fool! You killed us all!
Impressive, Arathiel. You really were close. A shame that you were too preoccupied with yourself to see it coming.
Beasts! You damn beasts! He was possessed! Possessed from the start!
Oh no, Arathiel. I'm afraid that is only half true. We reap, but you sowed. Of course we possessed him, but you did all the heavy lifting back in Kira when you gave the order to massacre everyone dear to him, including his wife and his poor, poor daughter. And so, it is a happy ending after all, isn't it? Without the Nerimos, you have nothing to use the beacon's power on. And the only thing it is good for now is the destruction of your own beloved city. It will be a feast, and there will be nothing left of you once we devoured you. Nothing but cold, gray flesh. It is just as we said. You have failed as you always have done. What is it, Arathiel? Lost your tongue?
No. No. I have not. Not at all. You have just presented me with a solution.
Are you deaf? There is no solution. The cleansing will happen, and you will all die.
Yes. Yes, we will. Your messiah, the citizens of the city, the armies, we will all burn like the sun. And then, it will be over.
You're fantasizing, Arathiel. Without...
Not this time. Here we must go our separate ways. Believe me, I wish it were otherwise. But in your condition, you would just be a burden. And I cannot afford any risks. I'm sorry. The High Ones are right. We cannot use the beacon to banish them anymore. But do you remember what the Archmagister said? Without the Numinos, the beacon's energy would burst out without direction. Cause a massive explosion, yes. And that is the only thing we can do for mankind now. Koarek was and is essential to the High One's plan. Whatever shape the actual cleansing takes, he wants to make sure it will happen. And we, Prophet, we may have failed in breaking the cycle for ourselves, but not for the others. The other people of this world, Araziel, Kira, Kilei, they're affected by the cycle as much as Enderal. And I know that there must be people like us. People who have had the same dreams and feel what is about to happen. And if we kill Koarek and his armies, we buy these people time. Time to gather knowledge, time to build a new beacon, and time to light it themselves. Those whom the Nerimes have not yet massacred anyway, you mean? They will die, as you and I will. But they will do so for mankind's salvation. And this is something worth dying for. It is the only way, don't you see? Either we die here, rotting with the Pyreans, or we choose to give our death meaning by at least stopping this fanatic Koarek and his armies. The High Ones are a lot weaker than they pretend to be. I feel it. We were so close to destroying them. And I have faith in the others out there who will fight them. They will succeed where this scum Sharim made us fail. So, a shepherd cannot decide the fate of his sheep. What is this really about, Prophet? Your life? Now is not the time for arrogance and selfishness. All of this is about more than just us. That you fail to see this disappoints me, Prophet. I thought better of you than that. But it does not matter anymore. I've made my choice. I'm sorry.
All begins with the dreams. Breathe. Enter the mind of a High One. I hope you're joking.
This was their last stand. They are afraid of us. I feel it. You've killed us! You've killed us all! You have just shown me the solution.
This is impossible. Why are you here? Be gone, Phantom. Be gone and leave me to my slumber. Then this isn't a dream. You really are here. But why? The Prophet dies when the Emperor leaves him. This is the course of the game. It has always been so. Explain yourself. How did you find this place? And why do you still exist? Her? But why? She does not have a mind. She does not have feelings. So why should she do this? But still you speak the truth. I can feel it. Then could it really be that the unlikeliest of all eventualities has become reality and brought you here? Coincidence or caprice, I do not know. The Veiled Woman cannot be understood. I am sorry. It's been too long since I have spoken to anyone. I have had many names. The Arcarians called me the God of Death. The Moonskin people, the Warden of Dreams. The Pyreans, the Demon of the Deep. For your people, I am, or was, the Black Guardian. Pompous names, I know. However, I am none of these, neither god nor demon. I am only an eye, condemned to observe again and again. As you measure time, older than your most daring chronicles go back, by far. I have seen them all, since our people fell. Every civilization, every cleansing, every turn of the cycle. What? No. The Starlings came long after me. I was only a fool who wanted to save his own skin at any cost. I knew the cleansing would come. I had known it long before the Red Madness and the war started. But I also knew that fighting it as my people did, and as most do, was pointless. So I looked for another way to prevail. And I found it. What you see here is the result. The Goliath, as I like to call it back then. What is it? My self-dug grave. What it was meant to be was a body of steel, an immortal machine with which I planned to merge my consciousness. Only organic life could be reaped by the High Ones. And I thought that by becoming a machine, I could fool them. By the name of the Sun, how brilliant I thought myself. I wanted to become a god, laughing in the face of time. But let me spare you my self-pity. What happened, happened. No. Joining the Goliath meant immortality. All I had to do was sleep and awaken once more when the cycle started again and new life came forth. Except that this new life would not have been defenseless. I would have been a true god to them, one capable of protecting them from the High Ones. No imaginary figure like the Creator. No false gods like the Lightborn were, to speak in your language. As the only one of my people? Yes. But it happened faster than it should have. And when the cleansing occurred, the Goliath was not yet finished. And as the Emperor unleashed the light, I had no choice but to complete the joining too early. A fatal error, as it turned out. I did survive, yes. But I am trapped inside this unfinished machine. And ever since then, all I can do is watch again and again. Yes, but a part of the Goliath is the eye. It allows me to see what happens on the surface everywhere. Not as literal as you imagine, of course. I see schemes, feel emotions, similar to your gift, to the Echo. But they are enough to understand. Yes, it was not how I planned it. The Goliath in its final form was meant to be divine, a synthesis of man and steel. But I overestimated myself, and I acted too quickly, driven by fear. No, no, you do not understand. You are stumbling through the fog, even now that it is almost over. By themselves, the High Ones are not the problem. If we would just see them as they really are, they would become powerless. Yes, it is hard to put into words.